Hey guys, this is Aaron. I'm in the process right now of recreating my Face Me component, and I've got my reference image placed in here. So the next step I gotta do is I gotta come in here and start putting geometry on here. So I'm gonna zoom in here. Whoa, that's too much me for me. But I'm gonna come in here and draw some lines. And what I'm gonna do is just trace around a portion of my image that I want to make into a surface. So I'm gonna start with the hair. I'm gonna click right here, and I'm just gonna move around every couple inches and just click to place a line. This doesn't have to be super exact. There we go. Click around something like that. You notice right now as I'm trying to drag down, I wanna come over back over to my head here, but it's snapping straight down. The further out I am, the harder that SketchUp's gonna try to pull towards axes. If I want to go just off an axis, I can zoom in a little bit and let me move my mouse over a little easier. All right, so I'm gonna continue on through here. Again, just clicking around. And right here, you'll notice I clicked off plane. So if I spin sideways, it actually came out like that. It is important as I'm clicking around to watch my cursor. So one of the big things I always want to keep an eye on is the color of that dot underneath the pencil. You can see right now it's purple. Purple means it is on the face of the image. As I was coming around there, it snapped off and snapped to the green axis, which is away from my image. So you have to be very careful, not very careful, just keep an eye on the color of that dot. Makes it pretty easy to go around and quickly place lines. All right, let me click around here. And then I'm going to click right here and hopefully close that surface. Yep, all closed up. I am gonna have a hard time speaking there, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select and delete the surface, and I'm gonna draw another shape right in here, something like this maybe. All right, so I have one surface. I did break my surface out here, so I just have to do something to make it regenerate. So I can click and draw a line over one of the edges, and it'll give me that surface back. Continuing around here, I might pick up where that last surface left off and start tracing around. I don't have to have just edge pieces either. I can come in and put a little detail like that, like my ear, maybe the back of my hair right here, come down my neck. And the idea here is not to be super precise and put a million lines in, but enough lines that it gives you the shape that you're looking for. All right, so right here, I did manage to create what should be a closed shape, but no surface popped up. Now there's a couple things I wanna look at here. One is I'm gonna spin it kind of sideways to make sure I don't have any lines shooting out of axis like I had before. Nope, looks good. So what I can do now is try to kind of encourage it to find those shapes. I do that by just drawing some internal lines. That was an easy one. I drew one line, it refound the geometry, everything was good. I'm gonna come out here, close up the rest of this face. And boom, closed. I might come in here and add a detail or two, something like that. You'll notice that some of these surfaces are backwards. That is something I want to correct. I do want to make sure that all of my surfaces are facing outward before I finish this model. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on those right now, right click, and say reverse faces. So I have white out there. Looking pretty good. Next step is going to be to click around here and get all the rest of these faces closed in. So I'm going to do that real quick right now. So quick, watch how fast this happens. Okay, now that I've got those lines in there, those surfaces created, I can move this image out of the way. At this point, I can go in and add colors. I can use the eyedropper tool to pick color swatches from the original photo, and then paint bucket tool to fill in each surface. Now that my face me is drawn, all that's left to do is make it a component and make it always face the camera. That's it for this skill builder. Thank you.